Hello students, in today's session we will solve one problem related to beam column. In the previous sessions we have discussed what is beam column. Beam column is a it can be a beam or it can be a column. It is not a separate member which I say it is a beam column member. No, it can be a beam, it can be a column, but while acting as a beam it is carrying one moment. While acting as a axially loaded column, it come across a moment and that extra moment cause it to behave as a beam column. Understood what I said? When the member which is actually designed for one kind of a force, axially loaded force or axially loaded column, come across a extra moment and that moment is enough to cause the influence in behavior, the moment is predominant, then we have to take it into consideration while designing that kind of a member, and that's what we called it as a beam column designing. Hope you are getting my point. Now if I want to solve one problem, in the problem you can come across two different data. One is, first data is that what is the force coming across it or force you have applying upon it, and what is the moment. That's the second different thing which comes into our question, and that kind of a problem when asked to design as a column. See, in the second unit we have designed the columns, right? And in that we have come across only the axial forces. They have never mentioned that there is a moment coming upon our column, right? But now they are saying design a column with the axial force as well as moment. You can see over here in the question they given a column having effective length of 3.5 meter is subjected to factor axial load. Is subjected to factor axial load of 450 kN and factor moment of 50 kN. Right? It means that even a column carrying a moment, how? That's why I'm saying I'm designing a beam column over here. It is not separately I'm designing a beam and I'm designing a column and combinedly I'm saying it as a beam column. No, it is not like that. How it is? The column is supposed to design for the compressive forces, but due to some manual or execution errors, there is a extra moment coming upon it, and that extra moment is called as a factored moment. At that extra moment is causing our design to be a beam column. Understood? Now next is question ask us design the column section with moment 50 kilonewton meter and with the axial loading of 450 kilonewton meter. Now that given data is mentioned over here. I wrote that in the initial part. Now I want it to start with the steps. So steps I have already discussed with you. As I want to design a column, I need to know what is design force it can resist, and accordingly I have to check the section, right? I will choose a section. For that I need to know what will be the design force, and design force it can be carry will be equals to FCD into effective area. Once I select the section, I will get to know what is effective area. How about FCD? Then how I will know FCD? Because PD is also not known, FCD is not known. Area will be choosed on the basis of how much force is exerted. Okay, now how we will solve? So we will go with the basic assumption as we did in the column members, designing in of a column member, that we have assumed some value of FCD. I have shared the details with you in the compression member designing in the second unit. I hope you have gone through it. Now here I have assumed FCD which is equals to 120 MPa Newton per mm square. Now area required, how to calculate area required and what is this FCD is? So FCD is design compressive stress, and stress we know, the stress is force per unit area. Now I want to know area. Area will be equals to what then? Force divided by compressive stress. So that's what we did over here. Area required will be equals to stress divided by force divided by stress. What is force? Force coming across a section is axial force of 450 kilonewton meter. Axial force of how much value? 450 kilonewton. This axial force divide by what? Divide by stress. Stress we assume how much? 120 MPa. Now area required will be how much then? 7500 mm square. If you calculate with your calci, you will come to know that area required is 7500 mm square. Once you calculate area, now the question you should come across and you should think, why madam has multiplied the area while taking force, why we multiply it with the 2? So see here, I have mentioned a note for it. Note says that area required will be trial section for the beam column is obtained by considering only an axial load, only an axial load of the magnitude of twice the actual axis or actual axial load. What I said, why I did multiplication with 2? Because I am assuming, I am multiplying, I am increasing my load, I am increasing my load twice of its original value. Why I am doing that? Because the column which I am designing is not only come across the axial forces, but it also come across a moment. It also comes across a moment which is of 50 kilonewton meter in this problem. We have not taken care of it. So we are assuming that axial load which is coming upon our cross section is twice as of the magnitude given in question. Therefore, I have multiplied my given value of axial force with 2. Now, once we get to know that area required is 750 mm square, I have to multiply, I have to use it where to select our section. What section I am designing with, what section I have selected to design this beam column condition? So I have chosen ISWB 400 at 66.7 kg per meter. Now why I am choosing this section? How I selected it? From the steel table. From the steel table you have to go to the beam section and from there you must check that what beam is providing 750 mm square area or more than that, at least 7500 mm square or more than that. Actually we select more than that. So area given by this section which I have selected ISWB 400 is 8501 mm square. Other properties from the steel table I have taken down: width of a flange, thickness of a flange, thickness of a web, and h. H is a distance between the. Now you have, this is I section. Let's suppose this is the I section, and these are the flanges of your I section, right? Now this flanges has some height h. This flanges has some height h, and that is 340.5 mm. That h is deducted from the total height, or h is calculated from the total height of your I section, deducting from what? Flange thickness. Okay. So this is mentioned everything in your steel table. I hope you are opening the steel table right now in while watching my session. It is advised to you that please carry your IS code steel table while watching my sessions and keep opening it, keep repeating the all the things I'm doing over here for you. You do simultaneously at your home, open the IS code, open the steel table, try to check out what I have said over in this video. Next is, once you write down the values, second thing is classification of section. क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ सेक्शन इज देर आर बेसिकली टू टाइप्स ऑफ क्लासिफिकेशन. वन इज द बेस्ट फॉर क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ सेक्शन एंड सेकेंड वन इज फॉर बकलिंग क्लासिफिकेशन. राइट, फर्स्ट इज द टू डिसाइड द गिवन सेक्शन इज प्लास्टिक और कॉम्पैक्ट, सेमी कॉम्पैक्ट और स्लेंडर. एंड सेकेंड क्लासिफिकेशन इज मेड टू क्लासीफाई अवर सेक्शन इन डिफरेंट बकलिंग क्लास गिवन इन द IS कोड इन टेबल नंबर 10. सो हियर आई एम सिलेक्टेड क्लास, आई एम ऑन द स्टेप वेयर आई एम क्लासीफाइंग माई सेक्शन वेयर आई हैव टेकन डाउन फर्स्ट रेशियो फ्रॉम द टेबल नंबर. ओपन द टेबल नंबर 10 फ्रॉम योर स्टील टेबल. क्विकली ओपन दिस टेबल एंड फ्लेंज वेन आई want to classify my I section, this classification is based upon two things, two ratios basically. First ratio is B by thickness of flange and second ratio is D by thickness of web. So for you, I have that table from the steel, from the IS code. Here you can see, if I want to classify my I section, the outstanding element of compression flange and then web of a I section, that's how you classify your section. How? First you need to check B by thickness of a flange ratio and then you have to check D by thickness of web ratio. How we did that? For the flanges you have to come to check first condition and second condition is for web. As your I section is divided into two parts, one is the flange part and second one is the web part. Okay, understood? So let's check the values and then we will cross verify it according to class. If the if it is lesser than 9.4 epsilon, then our section will be classified under plastic category. If it is false between 9.4 to 10, then it will be a compact section. If it is false between 9.5 to 15.7, then it is a semi-compact section. Okay, so let's check where our section falls. Yes, here. Now see the properties from the steel table and cross check along with me. First ratio is B by thickness of flange. So B is now divided by 2 here. Why? Because we don't want width of a flange. No. What we want? We want only the width of outstanding leg of a I section. This outstanding leg I section. Width of a flange means what? From end to end distance of a flange, right? Now we don't want that, we want width of a outstanding leg over here. Now B will be calculated by width of a flange divided by 2. Therefore I said B is equals to BF by 2. Then thickness of flange is given in steel table. Now calculate this ratio in your calculator, it will be valued as 7.69. And as of course it is less than 8.4, which is from the steel table, from IS table, table number 10, I have choose that value and it says that if your value of a ratio is less than 8.4 epsilon, then the flange will fall into plastic category. The flange will fall into what? Plastic category. Then for web, you have to check D by thickness of web ratio. D is H in divide by thickness of web. Okay, now this H1 is what? How I wrote D to the H1? Because D is a total depth of a flange. D is a total depth of a flange. Sorry, of your I section. Let's suppose this is your I section and total depth of it is 400, right? ISHB 400 section I have selected. But now I don't want this H equals to 4 because I want only the distance between the flange, that will be H1. okay, that is given in your steel table. You can choose from there. I have already mentioned it above. H1 will be 340 divided by 8.6 thickness of web. All the values are mentioned over here. See, H1, B, thickness of flange. You open the steel table, you will get all the same values in steel table. Now, this value falls less than 84 epsilon. Now, what is epsilon over here? Epsilon, you know already, it is root. It is, its value is, epsilon is equals to under root Fy by 250. So 250 is how much, Fy is 250. 250 divided by 250 becomes 1. Under root 1 is value 1. Therefore, epsilon carries value 1 over here. So this value is less than 84. It is less than 84 epsilon. Also, this value is less than 88.4 epsilon. So both the flange and web falls in a plastic range. Okay. So our section become, overall our section, I section, ISHB 400 become plastic section. Now, third step is, once we classified our section, third step is to calculate ND. Why we want to know ND? Because our strength calculation, because in the question they said calculate strength also. See here, they said check for the section strength. And what is the formula to check the section strength? In the steps I already mentioned you, it will be N divided by ND plus MZ divided by MDZ is should be less than 1. Okay, for that we require to know what is ND, and ND will be formula of it is here. That's why I am calculating ND. ND, I already told you this formula is mentioned in your steel table taken from the section. It is mentioned in your IS code and taken in from the section 6. Okay, so TDG is a tension value, tension strength, which we calculated for tension member designing. From there it is taken down. Okay, so AG divided by AG into FY divided by gamma naught. So ND will become 1932.04 kilonewton. Okay, calculate it in your calci, you will get the same value. Once you calculate design strength compression due to yielding, now we will move towards what? Design strength due to moment. What is that value? MD. Formula is also mentioned in your IS code. No need to mug up it. You can choose, or you can just open your IS code and you will get it there. Now, to use this formula, we required FD, because we know arrest ZP is a plastic section modulus, ZB is also the ratio of ZE divided by ZP, right? So everything else is known to us. We can take down it from the steel table, properties of that section. Only the unknown value is FD. How to calculate? F suffix BD. Now, to calculate that, we will take a help of, I already told you, table number 13 and 14. Table number 13 is divided into two parts, table number 13A and table number 13B. And second part is table number 14. Okay, so we need to take a help of these two tables. For that, to use that table, again, see, open your table number 14. Because 14 gives us F suffix CR comma B value. Okay, critical stress. Okay, now this table number 14 will give us a critical stress value, which we will use into table number 13 over here. In the table number 13. From here, we will calculate FBD. So, from table number 14, you need to take down what? From table number 14, you will calculate FCR, comma बी, एंड फ्रॉम टेबल नंबर 13 यू विल कैलकुलेट एफ बी डी. ओके, नाउ फॉर दिस वी विल डू स्टेप बाय स्टेप प्रोसीजर. जस्ट बी केयरफुल अबाउट इट, हाउ टू डू इट आई एम रिपीटिंग ओवर हियर. सी, दिस इज द टेबल यू रिक्वायर्ड टू चेक फ्रॉम योर IS code. Okay, this table says that to use table number 14 of your IS code, you required what? KL by R value, which is slenderness ratio, lambda, and H by thickness of flange, H by thickness of flange, which will gives us by this ratio. Okay, H is what? Depth of between flange to flange, and thickness of flange is already given in your properties of a section. From there we will choose the value between, the value is 26.19 for this, the value is 26.19, but in table number 14 we don't have 26.19 direct value, so we need to do interpolation. As well as the lambda value KL by R is 86.63. For this 86.63 and for this 26.19, we need a FCR, critical stress value. Now, how to do this? For that, we need to do interpolation. Now, interpolation is your, you're gonna do it on your own. I'm gonna explain you how to do it. See here. First, you have to interpolate between these two values. Once you come to know A value, then you interpolate between this two value. This will be your interpolation for B. This will be interpolation for A. Okay, first interpolation for A, then interpolation for B. I have given over here, you can take down from here, interpolation is a common thing. Then once you know A and B values, third interpolation will be for FCRB value. Third interpolation will be for FCRB value. Once you interpolate it, you will come to know what is FCRB value, that is, you can see over here, 363.67. Now, once we used this table number 14, now we want to go for what? Table number 13A, to know what? FBD. Now, FCRB value is false between what? 3.6, 3.67. And the question here remains unanswered is that we have two tables with us. We have two tables, table number 13A and table number 13B. Which one to use? That's the question, right? So to know which table to use, you have to understand that alpha thing. With this table, in the IS code, with this table, in the title of table, they have mentioned what? Alpha values. The alpha values need to be understand. Where from we will calculate this alpha values? That alpha values will be taken down from IS code, from the table number 7, called as the imperfection factor. See here, table number 4, table number 13A is given with the alpha value 0.21. This is for table number 13A, and for table number 13B, it is given with the alpha value 0.49. It is not given here, not visible here, but it is 0.49. Now, the question is how to select a table. Either we choose from the table number 13A or we should use table number 13B. For that, you have to know alpha value. You have to choose the alpha value based upon buckling class. So you need to calculate what first? Buckling class of your section. Once you know the buckling class, it can be from A, It can be from B or it can be from C and D. Which buckling class is for your section, that you need to calculate first. How you will calculate that? For that you need to do buckling classification. For that table number 10 is required. Right? Table number 10 is required. Yes. So open the table number 10 from your steel IS code and we will classify our section. Yes. So first that table says us the first ratio is H by B and the ratio falls greater than 1.2. Okay, so first condition is satisfied. And thickness of flange is lesser than 40. So second case also satisfied from the first row of table number what? Table number 10. Okay. We have used it many times. I hope you getting it. From there, I concluded that my classes can be from A or B because both of the condition has satisfied. So I will take down the values from both of the table. From the table 13A, I will calculate and interpolate for value 363.67 and I also use table number 13B and will calculate value for 363.67. This is so how I interpolated and calculated value of FBD and FBD for table from table number 13A and from table number 13B. Now which one to use here? Because our aim is to calculate MD, right? Now which one to use? MD will be based upon the lesser value of FBD. Because see, it is a strength. And if I choose the larger value, it will be automatically fail at this value before achieving its ultimate strength, right? Matlab 226 achieve hone se pehle at this stage, it will fail down. So I have to choose the lesser value and I will go with 187.50. Okay. How we calculated MD? With this formula. Formula is known to us. Ratio is 1. ZP value from steel table from the property section. FBD is 1 you calculated over here. These two values. Okay. Once you calculate that, put the use this formula to check the section strength. And the value for it should be taken from smaller value. So here at place of MDZ, I have chosen least value and I get to know that it lesser than 1.49. That's why I said it is safe. The section we selected is safe to use as a column beam section and used to place as a column section as mentioned in the question. To solve this problem, we need to take a help of multiple tables I have given over here. This is a table number, yes, this is a table number 2. I am using it for what? Limiting width to thickness ratio to classify our section in plastic, compact, semi-compact and slender section. If it fail to fall into 3 of the category, it will be a slender section. Then I have used this table, table 7 for imperfection factor, but my class is falled between A and B, therefore I have chosen values from both the table. Then this is the table which I am using for, yes, wait a minute, this is the table I am using for calculating FBD values. This is a table number 13A based upon the alpha value 0.21. The next table is for FBD for the alpha value. Alpha value will be 0.49. Then the last table I have used is table number 14 for the critical stress value and my value was for the KL by R and H by thickness of flange. So I hope you have getting my problem which I solved for you here. Solve same type of problem at home and you will get a better idea of it. If you have any questions, you can ask me in the comment box. Thank you so much.